All right, shalom.
Shalom.
And first, Thurman, giving all praise and glory to
Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahushai, Ba'ashem, HaKadosh.
The honors, the apostles, and those of the great most peace and mercy to the King David. Yahweh is the true name of the Heavenly Father, who the world calls God. Yahushai is the true name of the Heavenly Father, and the beloved Son, who the world refers to Jesus Christ. Ba'ashem is in the name of HaKadosh, the Holy Spirit. And shalom to the 44,000 men. As laboring this truth for the sake of Yahweh Hashem Hashem, and shall belong to the innumerable multitude, men, women, and children, and may be listening to all truth and sincerity, shall belong. It's your brother Kadash, and I'll come.
Brother Abwah.
We come back here with another video through the spirit and power of Yahweh Hashem Hashem. And, basically going into that the Lord is with us, and Lord willing, this is edifying.
Come, man, because a lot of times you might get caught up worrying in your flesh, is the Lord with me? What are we going to do in Jacob's trouble? And just, being in that carefulness spirit, that anxious spirit, man. But at the end of the day, we have to just trust in the fact that how much God is going to be with us, man. The first scripture I have lined up on deck is Ecclesiastes 2 and 10.
This is Sarah, Ecclesiastes chapter 2, verse 10. 2 and 10 says, look at the generations of old and see that ever any trust in the Lord and was confounded, or did any abide in his fear and was forsaken? Or whom did he ever despise that falls upon him?
That's right, man. So we have to look upon the past examples of our forefathers, man, and see, man, whoever trusted in the Lord and was confounded, man. All of our righteous forefathers through time and time again who called on the name of Yahweh Bashmashai and trusted in truth and in spirit and in sincerity, man, the Lord came through, man. Okay? It might not have always been when we want it to happen, but it'll happen, man, in the right time, man, in due season, but we have to trust in that, man, and we also have to learn to adapt, because sometimes we find ourselves in uncomfortable situations or situations that are not necessarily ideal or whatnot, but we have to learn to roll with the punches and flow in the spirit, man, and keep the faith, because not everything is going to be picture perfect. If it was always picture perfect, where's the need to have faith, man? Where's the need to have perseverance and endurance and fortitude, man, So we have to learn to trust in the Spirit at all times, even when it doesn't look promising, man. You know what I'm saying? Scripture says in Romans the 8th chapter, we are saved by hope. But hope that we can see. Why do we yet hope for it? Roughly paraphrasing.
Go ahead. Hebrews chapter 6. And I'll just get to the point, verse 10. It says, but the Most High is not unrighteous to forget your work and labor of all, which he has shown towards his name, and that he had ministered to the saints and do minister. So all of our forefathers, all our righteous forefathers, they all, they did the work of the Lord. All right, they abided in his fear. They followed his commands. King David, he was a man after the Lord's heart. So we follow those righteous examples that we have, at the time that we're coming into, the time of Jacob's trouble, and all hell breaking loose. All right, what Scripture says in the second answer is that he's a guide to them that keep his commandments and precepts. So the Lord's going to be guiding us at that time. And the Lord, he's guiding us now.
That's right.
We already, because this is like practice, and Jacob's trouble, that's going to be game day. So we're practicing and, we're rehearsing the righteous acts now.
That's right. Out of Isaiah 46. This is Isaiah chapter 46, starting at verse 3. It says, hearken unto me, O house of Jacob, and all the remnant of the house of Israel, which are born by me from the belly, which are carried from the womb. And even to your old age I am he, and even to hoar hairs will I carry you. I have made, and I will bear, even I will carry and will deliver you. You see, so the Lord, he's been with us since the womb. You have a priest on the lot?
I was trying to get
Psalms 116, Bible for sure. Because the Lord, he's been with us since the womb, man. Okay? And from the time that you were a sperm cell to the time you went through the gestation period in your mother's womb, okay? Your heart, your limbs started to grow. You got air in your lungs. All the way to the present day age now. Even if you have gray hairs in your head, Yahweh Hashem Hashem has been with us, man. If we're of his elect. And it tells us that in Psalms 116. Bob Truck, can you start from the top and then, read just flow through Bob Truck?
This is Psalms 116, starting at 1. I love the Lord, Yahweh, because he has heard my voice and my supplications, because he hath inclined his ear unto me. Therefore will I call upon him as long as I live.
And that's what we need to do, man. Continually call upon Yahweh Bashmashai, as long as we have breath in our lungs, man. You know? Should not a day go by where we don't acknowledge Yahweh Bashmashai, man. The Lord speaks about how his people have forgotten him days without number. We're not supposed to be in that spirit. You got it, brother.
Verse 3 says, the sorrows of death compassed me, and the pains of hell got hold upon me. I found trouble and sorrow. Then called I upon the name of the Lord Yahweh. Oh, Yahweh, by Hashem Yahashai, I beseech thee, deliver my soul.
Right, man. And even though this isn't the precept I wanted, so Salakia, but this still works out through the Spirit, man, because we need deliverance in these times, man. We're coming into a time of trouble the world has never seen before, man. You know, and these are the type of prayers we need to be praying on a daily basis. How much more in the times of Jacob's trouble, man?
Right, he said, deliver my soul. And who is the deliverer? All right, Yahweh Shai. So we're praying to the Heavenly Father, you know, through Yahweh Shai,
mm-hmm.
you know, for Yahweh Shai to deliver us. And, and that's what he's going to do. He's going to deliver, you know, his hopeful elect. And Lord, we're,
yep.
you know, we are of that number.
Yep. Hey, Shalom, everybody in the comment board. Yahweh Shai, about the comment. Shalom. Baba Shai, it was Psalms 139.
Psalms 139, start the top.
Baba Shai.
Oh yeah, how will thou search me and know me? Thou knowest my down sitting and my uprising. Thou understandest my thought afar off.
Hey, that was spiritual because I just sat up and I sat down. That's, the Lord knows all that. You got that, brother.
Verse 3 says, thou compassest my path and my lying down and art acquainted with all my ways. For there is not a word in my tongue, but lo, O Lord Yahweh, thou knowest it altogether.
Yeah, and Yahweh Shai said that. You know, your Father knows the things you have need of before you even ask him, man. You know? So Yahweh Shai, he knows what we need. He knows what we want, okay? And he's going to make sure to come through as long as we're holding up our end of the bargain. Avarazah, you know? But you got it, brother.
Verse 5 says, thou hast beset me behind and before, and laid thine hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is high, I cannot attain unto it. Whither shall I go from thy spirit, or whither shall I flee from thy presence? If I ascend up into heaven, thou art there. If I make my bed in hell, behold, thou art there. If I take the wings of the morning, and dwell in the uttermost parts of the sea, even there shall thy hand lead me, and thy right hand shall hold me. You know, so it don't matter where we are, man.
Right,
the Lord have us scattered to another country in the time of Jacob's trouble.
Right.
You know, it don't matter where, the Lord is going to be with us, man, because the Lord is omnipotent, man.
Right.
He's in all places, he's everywhere, man.
What?
Verse 11, where it says, if I say, surely the darkness shall cover me, even the night shall be light about me.
Mm-hmm.
Yea, the darkness hideth not from thee, but the night shineth as the day. The darkness and the light are both alike to thee.
Right, so regardless of how much darkness you got around about you, the Lord still sees you. Okay, no matter how much light is around you, the Lord still sees you, man. It's all the same to him. You can't hide from the Lord, man. And that's basically what this chapter is going into in its beginning half, man. Basically going into how, you know, wherever we go, like the brother said, the Lord's spirit is with us, man. And when you read the scriptures, what did it say about King David? It said the Lord preserved David whithersoever he went, man. And we pray that we be of the house of David and that we receive of the mercies, the ever sure mercies of David, man. So guess what? Those same blessings that the Lord had upon King David are going to be upon us, man. Does not the scripture say, he that is feeble among them shall be as David, man? And the house of David shall be as God, as the angel of the Lord before them, man. So you got to understand, man, that if we have the Lord's Holy Spirit in us, that's like a spiritual GPS tracking device. You know, it's like, hey, there goes my elect. You know, he's traveling up I-95. He's going to this brother's house. He's going to work right now. You know what I'm saying? The Lord always got tabs on us, man. So we don't have to trip about nothing, man. Wherever we go, Yahweh Bashmashai is with us, man. And the brother got something, but Lord willing, we'll go back to it.
You got it, Lord. Yeah, just a quick precept. He said, whithersoever. This is Joshua 1 and verse 7 says, only be thou strong and very courageous, that thou mayest observe to do according to all the law, which Moses, my servant, commanded thee. And that's what we're doing now, where we are rehearsing the righteous act.
Mm-hmm.
It says, turn not from it to the right hand or to the left, that thou mayest prosper whithersoever thou goest. So we don't turn away from Yahweh by Shem HaShem. We don't neglect the gift, which is the Holy Spirit that has been upon us. The Lord's going to be with us wherever we go.
Right. Beautiful, beautiful.
I'll jump back to Psalms 139. And
verse 13?
Okay, verse 13. It says, for thou hast possessed my reins, thou hast covered me in my mother's womb.
Mm-hmm. So the Lord was with us even in the womb. You know what I'm saying? He sanctified Jeremiah, a prophet, from his mother's womb. Same thing with all the men of the Lord, really. Okay? Lord willing, we be upon the like number. We've been sanctified since the womb. Like the scripture says, this child is born of the Holy Spirit. Meaning what? That the Spirit of the Lord has been with us since we were babes, man. Abarach Zal, we be those men. Okay? You got it out.
Verse 14 says, I will praise thee, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are thy works, and that my soul knoweth right well. My substance was not hid from thee, when I was made in secret, and curiously wrought in the lowest parts of the earth.
Mm-hmm.
Thine eyes did see my substance, yet being imperfect. And in thy book all my members were written, which in continuance were fashioned, when as yet there was none of them.
Right, so basically, before you were even like fully developed as a baby, and you were in your mother's womb, the Lord said all of our members was written in his book, man. The Lord had us in remembrance, man. The scripture say, can a nursing, it's in Isaiah where it says, can a nursing mother forget her sucking child? You can just type in engraved hands, engraved. He said, I engraved thee in the palm of my hands, man. Yeah, man, so the exaltation that hand pretty much is really, the Lord is with us, man. We don't have to worry. As long as we're doing what we need to do in the spirit, you will have ever sure confidence in Yahweh Hashem Shai will help you. The scriptures say the fear of the Lord is strong confidence. So if you're fearing the Lord, you're going to be confident the Lord's going to be with you. And you need this confidence coming into these times that we're coming into, man. Because we're coming into some evil times, man. Shit's getting crazy out here, man. That's why the scriptures say in Isaiah 33 and 6, wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability at times, man.
This is Isaiah 49, verse 16. Says, behold, I have graven thee.
Can you start up a little further where it says sucking mother, Dr. Church? Or sucking child? Nursing mother, something like that?
Yeah, verse 15, it says, can a woman forget her sucking child that she should not have compassion in the son of her womb? Yea, they may forget, yet will I not forget thee.
Woo!
Hey, that
is a
minute. Come to yourself. Because, even in the times that we're in now, there's literally women out there, it's like the ostrich in the wilderness.
Yep, yep.
Careless with their children, man.
Mm-hmm.
But Yahweh Shema Shai is, he had never forsaken Israel, but started with the elect on this side. He has reserved men and women and children, to be delivered out of this place.
That's right. That's right.
Verse 16 says, behold, I have graven thee upon the palms of my hands, thy laws are continually before me.
Mm-hmm. That's right, man. The Lord said he graved us in the palms of his hands, man. So we're ever with the Lord, man. It may not be the best analogy, but when you need to remember something, what do? You write it down on your hand, man. I ain't trying to be over righteous, but making ink on your skin and shit, that might be going on. But nonetheless, it's like, and for the sake of the analogy, man, the Lord has given an analogy. It's a metaphor, man. I've engraved you on the palm of my hand, man. And I'm sure there's a deeper meaning behind that. But through the Spirit, basically the Lord's showing you, look, I can never forget about you, man.
As long as you can see it, everything, you see your hands and you're good.
Right. And when they say, it like the back of your hand.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So that's what it is, man.
And that one Christian pastor, Joyce Meyer, yes, she used that same scripture. Saying that getting a tattoo of a pastry
Oh, wow.
He has got a tattoo of her on her hand. That's thoroughly the same scripture.
Hey, God. Hey. They wrestle the scriptures, man. That's what you about them wrestling the scriptures to their own destruction. But that's the point.
Let me go back to Psalms.
We can drop Psalms. Let's go to wrap it up. I have one last pre. Lord Willis and Isaiah 54. Oh, yeah, go ahead, brother.
Yeah, I want to speak about this. Jeremiah 3 and starting at 11, it says, "And the Lord, Yahweh, said unto me, the backsliding Israel hath justified herself more than treacherous Judah. Go and proclaim these words towards the north and say, return, thou backsliding Israel." And, you know, and we are in the north. This is North America. You know, this is, you know, where a majority of Israelites are. Right? All right. So we prophesy in Babylon. Right?
Mm-hmm. All
right. The Lord said to Jeremiah as well that he's going to deliver us from that from the north country, roughly paraphrased.
Right.
It says, "Saith the Lord, and I will not cause my anger to fall upon you, for I am merciful, saith the Lord, and I will not keep anger forever. Only acknowledge thy iniquity, that thou hast transgressed against the Lord thy power, and hast scattered thy ways to the strangers under every green tree, and ye have not obeyed my voice, saith the Lord. Turn, O backsliding children, saith the Lord, for I am married unto you. I will take you one of a city and two of a family, and I will bring you to Zion." So the Lord is going to lead his elect, you know, to ultimately being beamed up.
Right?
Right, we're looking to be beamed up on the chariots, you know, as Babylon is being destroyed.
Right.
But the key thing, you have to turn back.
Right.
It says it was for our ways to go, for as much as we was going astray from the Lord, and how we return.
This is Baruch 4:28. It says, "For as it was your mind to go astray from Yahweh by Shoshai, so be returned, seek him 10 times more.
Right. 10 is completion, man. All right. So you can never go far enough, man. And now speak of another scripture.
You know, like I said, seek him 10 times. Now, go ahead, Wallah. Go ahead. I don't want to punch you.
No, I think because we started out Sirach, the second chapter, because it says, you know, woe to them that are faint hearted, for he will not defend you.
Right, right.
You know, so if you don't believe in the Abba Shemayah Shah, the supreme power, he's not going to deliver you, bro.
Right.
All right, because the Lord, he don't need us, man. We need him.
Right. Hey, scripture speak about those who are faint hearted and fearful, they're going to end up in the lake of fire. Revelation 21:8. You know? And
One of those words in there. Faint-hearted means like weak-minded.
Right.
You know, so you gotta be a man, you gotta gird yourself up and be a man to serve the Lord.
Hey, that's a beautiful point you made out, because it says weak-minded, right? Doesn't the scripture say, put off now the weak nature, cast away the burdens of man? It tells us in 2 Ezra 14:14, let go from the immortal thoughts, cast away the burdens of man, put off now the weak nature, and set aside the thoughts that are most heavy unto thee, and haste thee to flee from these times. You see? So, hey, what does it say? Cast away the burdens of man. A part of a burden of a man is doubt. Having weak, being weak-minded. You know, wishy-washy, unsure, man, the Lord with me. The Lord wants you to have that confidence, man, that he's with you, man. But in order for you to have that confidence, you got to have the words to back up your faith. Straight up, man. You know? Okay, like the brother brought out earlier, seeking 10 times more, man, because what do they say? When they usually do a rating, they say what? 10 out of 10. You know, 10 times 10 is 100. It's 100%. It's perfection, man.
Oh, yeah.
Perfection. You know? Yeah, yeah. Through the Spirit. Yeah. Come, man. So that's the point on that right there, man. You know? We got to seek the Lord 10 times more, man.
You want me to grab?
Isaiah, Bible Strong.
Isaiah
54. And you can start at verse 7.
This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 54, starting at verse 7. It says, "For a small moment I have forsaken thee, but with great mercy will I gather thee."
Mm-hmm. Because that's what happened as a nation of Israel. We got cut off as a nation, man. You know, just like when a man dealing with a woman, you know, for a period of time, depending on how rocky the relationship was, sometimes the woman get cut off, man. You know? But what happens? Eventually, Lord willing, they reconcile, man. You know what I'm saying? It's the same thing. The Lord said, in a small moment, I forsook you, but with great mercies will I guide thee. And that's happening right now, man. You know, through this ministry. This is a part of the Lord's mercy right here. You got it up.
As Jesus said, in a little while, I hid my face from thee for a moment, but with everlasting kindness will I have mercy on thee, saith the Lord, and I will God redeem us. For this is as the waters of Noah unto me. For as I have sworn that the waters of Noah should no more go over the earth, so have I sworn that I will not be wroth with thee, nor will be thee. For the mountains shall depart, and the hills be removed, and my kindness shall not depart from thee, neither shall the covenant of thy peace be removed, saith the Lord Yahweh, that have mercy on me.
Right, man. So the Lord is like, look, the mountains going to be departing, the hills going to be removing, the earth is going to be going through shaking and trembling. But the Lord said his mercy will not depart from us, man. So while all hell breaking loose, Yahweh is still going to gather us and lead us and direct us and have mercy upon us, man. You gotta think about it. 1,000 fall at thy side, 10,000 at thy right side, but it shall not come nigh thee, man. Because the Lord is with us, man. And we're not gonna have to worry, man.
And verse 10 was the spirit, because I was literally looking up covenant. And in verse 10 it says, for the mountains shall depart and the hills be removed, and thy kindness shall not depart from thee, neither shall the covenant of my peace be removed, said the Lord of hell that have mercy on thee. You know, so the Lord, he made a covenant, man, that he was going to give us new bodies. You know, starting with the elect, give us new bodies, and we're going to keep the law perfectly, you know, and we're going to live forever, immortality, man.
Yeah.
And that word covenant says a mutual compact to do something or not to do something. But the Lord said he will do something, he will deliver us, man, as long as we return back unto him. You know, and that's part of that, because he broke the first covenant. That's why we're under the curses now. We're in captivity. You know, but we're in that grace period now. You know, to where our sins are being forgiven, you know, and we can return back into the Lord through Yahweh Shah, man. Because he died for the forgiveness of sins, man, starting with the elect.
Right. Huh? Come, man. And even just bounce off verse 10 too, where, you know, basically all that chaos and turmoil is going on. How does the Lord take a trouble? You know, wild beasts on the loose, famine, pestilence, martial law, 2/3 with the sword. You know what I'm saying? All these different calamities and chaos, but yet you have our son's kindness will still be with us, man. That's a big deal, man. So don't worry, the Lord got us, man. Okay? As long as you're doing what you need to be doing for Yahweh's love side, the Lord will take care of you, man. That's a part of the bargain. That's a part of the deal. This is what we signed up for. The Lord is not like Esau. You know, he's a just power. He's a just boss. And not that we serve the Lord to receive a reward per se, like, oh Lord, I did this, so now you gotta do this. It's not a you scratch my back, I scratch yours type of deal. But the Lord is like, look, this is included in the contract, you know, metaphorically speaking, man. You know what I'm saying? Having spiritual power, divine intervention, you know, mercy from the Lord. You even see that on small scales already, man. You know, in our day-to-day lives. So how much more in the time of Jacob's coming, where it's going to be a time of trouble the world has never seen before? You think the Most High is going to sit back and chill and kick his feet up and let us fend for ourselves? No, man. You know, we're known as the apple of his eye, man. He's going to make sure to watch over us, man. You know, Abraham Zah, we be a part of that elect number.
Yeah, like you said, you know, spiritual power and all that, that's just a part of it. You know, those mm-hmm. are like perks.
Yeah.
You know, because it says, rejoice not that the spirits are subject unto you, but rather that your names are written in heaven. So we do this, we don't want to receive a nuclear missile, man.
Right.
Like, we're trying to escape destruction, man.
Right. You got anything else for us? Good. Hey, Lord willing, let's know. Is that a fine, man? Keep your head up.
You know, like your brother said, you know, Lord willing, let's know. You know, Lord, and give all praise, honor, and glory to your
Father. I will, by some, by shy, by some type of God.
Double honor to the apostles and others of the great mystical. Peace and mercy to the house of David. Until the next lesson, for so long.
So long.
Bob.
Bob.